This video is a production of the Reunion Committee, Class of 1944, Springfield, Missouri Senior High School. We are indebted to Charles Espy for supplying an old movie on videotape. We're also indebted to Harold Robert Smith for filming most of the videos on this production, and there are some still photographs pictured that were taken by Don Akers.
Welcome back to Senior High School. I'm Charlie Espy, with principal here in the 1970s. You know, Senior High was changed to Central High School when Parkview was opened in 1953, whenever, 1957. Central High School was almost closed in the late 70s by the Board of Education, and a meeting was held right there in the auditorium, a rather heated town meeting, and the decision was changed to leave Central open. This film was discovered in the 70s, was made in 1941-42. We believe it was for the purpose of a bond issue for the R-12 skate. You're now looking at the West Wing, Central High School, built in 1898. This was the original wing of Central High School. Have a happy reunion.
Thank you. It's my day. Bend an ear and listen to my version
of a really solid Tennessee excursion.
Pardon me, boy, is that the Chattanooga Juju?
Yes, yes, track 29.
Boy, you can give me a shine.
Can you afford to board Chattanooga Choo-Choo?
I got my fare
and just a trifle to spare.
You leave the Pennsylvania station about a quarter to four. Read a magazine and then you're in Baltimore.
Dinner in the diner, nothing could be finer
than to have your ham and eggs in Carolina.
When you hear the whistle blowing 8 to the bar, then you know that Tennessee is not very far.
Shamalala calling, gotta keep it rolling.
Ooh, ooh, Chattanooga, there you are.
there's gonna be a certain party at the station.
Satin and lace.
I used to call funny face. She's gonna cry until I tell her that I'll never roam.
So Chattanooga choo-choo,
won't you choo-choo me home?
Chattanooga, Chattanooga,
get aboard.
Chattanooga, Chattanooga,
all aboard.
Chattanooga, Chattanooga, Chattanooga choo-choo,
won't you choo-choo me home?
Chattanooga choo-choo.
Thank you.
A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I got a gal
in Kalamazoo.
Don't want to boast, but I know she's a toast
of Kalamazoo, zoo, 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 zoo.
Years have gone by.
She grew.
I liked her looks when I carried her books
in Kalamazoo, zoo, 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 zoo.
I'm gonna send a wire hopping on a flight
leaving today.
Am I dreaming? I can hear screaming.
Hiya, Mr. Jackson. Everything's okay. A-L-A-M-A-C-O. Oh, what a girl.
I'll make my bid for that freckle-faced kid I'm hurrying to.
I'm going to Michigan to see the sweetest girl
in Kalamazoo.
Zoo, 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 Kalamazoo.
Thank you. bring my baby back home. We go along, harmonizing a song. Snuggles her head to my chest. We started to pet, but that's when I get her powder all over my vest. That's when I kinda straighten my tie. She has to borrow my coat. One kiss, then I continue again, walking my feet.
This memory board for the class of 1944 has been presented to Central High School and is now in their archives room.
every man is a piece of the continent, a part of the main. Any person's death diminishes me because I am involved in humanity. That just about says it all for me. As a member of the class of 44, then and now, I find that my life is diminished in remembering those who have not survived to this time. Whether I knew them well, as I did some of them, or knew them casually, as I did some others, or knew them not at all, I feel that my life is diminished and the quality of this evening is tarnished by the fact that they are not here. Shall we pray? O God, our Father, in this moment of reflection and recollection, we do remember those who have not survived to share the moment with us. It is with tenderness in our hearts that we are reminded of the contribution that they have made to us. But remembering this, we ask you to share the evening with us. And now let the celebration continue. Amen.
Thank you. Yeah, she's here somewhere. She's in the yellow suit whenever she heard.
Lined up.
Hi, sir. How are you doing?
Gotcha, Lord, gotcha.
Thank you.
These video noise lines are the result of our having to edit 10 hours of tape down to 2 hours.
are, as you already know, the Central High School Kilty Drum and Bugle Corps. At this time, we would like to ask Mrs. Francine Dimler Knox, the former 1994 Kilty Majorette, to come forward, along with any other Kilty in the audience.
Thank you. 50 bucks. With a little work on my part, I can make my own.
Actually, I was asked by the planning committee, who, by the way, did a hell of a job. To prepare a dissertation and discuss for at least an hour the pricing policies of the worldwide pharmaceutical industry, which I had the opportunity to spend 42 years in. But since time is kind of tight, and since you're so interested in it, I thought I wouldn't do it. I want to do something else. Yeah. Hey. And this is going to be mercifully short. This comes to you courtesy of Wade Lawson and Harriet Hutchins sent it to me. That's Wade, huh? And it hit me, I'd heard this before, but when I read it, I thought, gee, what a great occasion for it. For the class of 1944, we are survivors. Consider the changes that we have witnessed. We were born before television, before penicillin, before polio shots, frozen foods, Xerox, plastic, contact lenses, frisbees, and the pill. We were before radar, credit cards, split atoms, laser beams, and ballpoint pens. Before pantyhose, dishwashers, clothes dryers, electric blankets, air conditioners, drip dry clothes, and before man walked on the moon. We got married first and then lived together. How quaint can you be? In our time, closets were for clothes, not for coming out. Bunnies were small rabbits, and rabbits were not Volkswagens. Designer jeans were scheming girls named Jean, and having a meaningful relationship meant getting along well with your cousins. We thought fast food was what you ate during Lent, and outer space was the back of the Gilroy's Theater. We were before house husbands, computer dating, dual careers, and computer marriages. We were before daycare centers, group therapy, and nursing homes. We never heard of FM radio, tape decks, electric typewriters, artificial hearts, word processors, yogurt, and guys wearing earrings. Who got the earrings? For us, time sharing meant togetherness, not computers or condominiums. A chip meant a piece of wood. Hardware meant hardware, and software wasn't even a word. In 1940, made in Japan meant junk, and the term making out referred to how you did on your exam. See, I remember that a little different than that. Pizzas, McDonald's, and instant coffee were unheard of. We hit the scene when there were 5 and 10 cent stores where you bought things for 5 and 10 cents. For one nickel, you could ride a streetcar or a bus, make a phone call, buy a Pepsi, or enough stamps to mail one letter and 2 postcards. You could buy a new Chevy coupe for $600, but not from Lakes. But who could afford one? A penny too, as gas was 11 cents a gallon. In our day, cigarette smoking was fashionable. Grass was mowed, Coke was a cold drink, and pot was something that you cooked in order to something else you did something else. Rock music was a grandma's lullaby, and aides were helpers in the principal's office. We were certainly not before the difference between the sexes was discovered, but we were surely before the sex changed. We made do with what we had, and we were the last generation that was so dumb to think you need a husband to have a baby. No wonder we are so confused, and there is such a generation gap today, but we have survived, and we've survived one hell of a long time. We survived World War II and what have you. What better reason to celebrate the 50th year reunion of the class of 44? And Wade, thank you and Harriet for sending me this, and I got off the hook and had a lot of fun dancing.
Thank you.
Charles Brock, Mrs. Brock.
Did you get a picture of that, Bob?
Yes, I did, too. You don't get an opportunity very often to catch them that way.
Is this going to be on the main fly or my...
I don't know. I've got 10 hours to get back to 5, so...
But it's going to be part of the one that's $15?
We're going to try to make it that part. That's the only dancing part I have for it right now.
Right here.
This is Carol Lee. Oh, here we are. All righty.
Yeah, I bet on this, but it does. Come back.
All righty.
Okay.
Well, we got your recorder, Herman.
All right.
Both in there.
Hi, Bob. I'm Jim Taylor from St. Louis. My wife, Billy. We're having a great time with this party.
We're glad to have you here.
Don't see everybody.
Don't stay away so long now. Well, we'll have to get another good time together here.
You remember Mary Louise here next to me?
It's true. We'll get her right now.
Hi, I'm Mary Louise. Hi, Nancy. I too am from San Luis. I've had a great time. It's been fun to see everyone.
All right.
Like we usually do, we had to spread out a little bit.
See you
in the next 50.
All right, that's Mr. Bill, right?
Right. Having a ball.
Having a ball. Well, hope we get to do this again sometime. What's your name and where you're from?
Randy Irwin.
John Q. Hammond's Tower is across the street from the Holiday Inn Hotel. It's 18 stories high, and the Tower Club is on top. These pictures were taken by Bob Smith, and copies may be obtained from him. These pictures were taken by Don Akers, and copies may be obtained from Don. We hope you enjoyed the 50th reunion, and we look forward to seeing you again in 5 years. This is Marge Pettit and the Greg James Trio. They provided the entertainment and dancing music. These pictures were taken at a wrap-up committee meeting at Harriet Hutchins' home. Adios, amigos. Sayonara.